black holes. They are very exotic objects. We are talking about an object that is kind of a one-way door out of our universe, in the sense that once you pass through the event horizon, there is no coming back, not even light can escape, hence the name black hole. It all started as some kind of a mathematical curiosity, so these are solutions to Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity, and for a long time people thought that this kind of beasts can't exist, that even though they are allowed by the theory, something in nature would prevent such an odd thing from forming. But now we have a lot of evidence for the existence of black holes. There are the gravitational wave observations of coalescence of black holes from the 2015 and onwards with the LIGO collaboration. There is the Event Horizon Telescope collaboration's image of how light behaves around a black hole and forms this kind of a fiery ring and a shadow of a black hole. One common misconception is that they are some kind of cosmic vacuum cleaners that go around and eat everything. Yes, if you come too close to a black hole and past the event horizon, there is no coming back, and yes, you are stuck there. But the way they affect their surroundings is basically through gravity. They attract you like any other object through the gravitational force. So if the sun would now turn into a black hole, the Earth would continue circling it. We wouldn't be sucked into the black hole, but we would continue circling it. Of course, it would become awfully cold in here. If we have a small black hole, when you come close to a black hole, outside of the event horizon, the tidal forces would be so strong that you would already be spaghettified before passing through the event horizon. There's a different amount of gravitational pull to your feet than to your head if you are falling feet down. The gravitational field changes with your length so much that your feet would feel much a larger pull than your head, and you would become thinner and thinner and thinner, and that would be the end of you. Then again, if we have a much more massive black hole, like the black hole in the center of M87, more than 6 billion solar masses, since the size of the event horizon depends on the mass of the black hole, the event horizon is much, much further away, and you wouldn't necessarily experience strong tidal forces, and you could pass the event horizon without actually much noticing it. You can't go back anymore, but you wouldn't notice anything drastic there. At some later point, yeah, you would be spaghettified as well, and whatever reminds of you ends up into the singularity. What happens there, we actually do not know. Our theory is not valid in that region anymore. The black holes that we know of are so far away that they pose no threat to us here on the Earth or to our solar system. So black holes do not actually have any effect on our daily lives.